Good day, guys. Welcome for one another Facebook Live session with the champions from Aussie's team. As we guys know that Australia is a very young country and it's a place of dreams. It's also a trades, it's an economy of trades, and the courses which international students possess here makes a big difference in our economy. Today we'll be talking about the most popular and the preferred courses amongst the international students in vet sector. We have seen a high demand of skilled construction workers in Australia, and we would be discussing about the construction trade today. We'll be talking about entry requirements, pathways, colleges, available intakes, scholarships, and immigration. We have Simple Preet Kaur, who is a champion from our migration team. As you guys know that Aussies as a brand, and it's one of the biggest education and migration companies in Australia, and that is the reason you could see there are beautiful faces from each and every state what we have, and they are basically coming up to give information from their states. Let's start straight away with the entry requirements. Today, as we said, we'll be talking about the construction vet courses. On Facebook, when we are live, please feel free to give any questions related to the courses or the migration, and we'll be taking them as time comes along. So let's start with Himanshu. Himanshu, can you please tell us about the requirements, entry requirements for trade courses?
Sure, Mangesh. First of all, I would like to thank you for the great introduction that you've given us. And at the same time, good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us. We have a very expert panel here from every region important major cities, in Australia. Also, would like to thank the viewers for joining us. I'm sure it will be a very important session for all of us. When we talk about entry requirements, there are a few things which the student can keep in mind when they are planning about trade courses. And today, since we are talking about construction, it's a part of a trade course itself. Why we are talking about construction? Because it's the major specialization, or it's a major area where most of the people are interested in. At the same time, it's quite important when it comes to your future pathways in Australia as well. So that's why we are touching base on construction more than any other trade course. Of course, we'll be bringing on more and more information about other trade courses as well, but construction itself, it's not just about one occupation or one trade course. It's about more than one number of occupations which are a part of construction itself. So talking about the entry requirements, we can talk about the prerequisites first of all. So students who want to start the trade course or construction, so basically the construction would start from certificate 3. It can go on to certificate 4, diploma, advanced diploma. So to start certificate 3, basically the prerequisite or the previous qualification which the student should be having is year 12. So you should be a high school graduate in order to apply for a trade course. Now, if I talk about high school, you also have to keep one more thing in mind, that it should be you should be more than 18 years of age. So after fulfilling these two criteria, you are straight away eligible to apply for a trade course if your visa allows, or if you're applying for a new visa. So this is how you can start your journey in the trade courses. Now, when it comes to the English requirements. So English requirement is basically IELTS equivalent to 5.5 and 42 to 43 of PTE. So this is the least English score that you need to get into a trade course, especially with certificate 3. Now, if you have finished 2 years of qualification in Australia or any other English speaking country, then especially in Australia, if I talk about, then certificate 4 and above courses overall for 2 years can basically waive off your English requirement. So this is how the entry requirement for a general entry requirement for students would work out to be, unless the colleges have their own placement test and based on which you can fulfill that too.
Sorry, Himanshu, there was a question here where somebody asked that if they don't get IELTS or PTE, what would be the sort of entry point? And as you said, the every college or school might have Absolutely. Their own exam, right?
Bang on, like perfect timing of for the question, because I was just about to answer that. If the colleges, because most of the colleges have their own English tests as well. They call it language placement test, or some colleges call it English placement test. So it's a normal English test itself. So just to meet the entry requirements, if the student is not fulfilling the English criteria, this can still be sorted out. So that this is why, like, you know, our role as an education counselor becomes more important, because we know which colleges have which requirements. So it can be a case-to-case basis as well for you to meet the entry requirements. Don't get disheartened. We are there for you. We can take care of your entry requirements as well. So that shouldn't be a problem. No matter how difficult the case is, we have the expertise to deal with. Now, if you're not 18 years of age, then of course, there are other ways that it can always support you. Just to highlight that a bit, you need a guardian to support you to get through the 18 years of age bracket. So yeah, to know more about that, of course, you can come and talk to us. In the current scenario, you can give us a call and we will be able to help you. Now, when we talk about pathways, when it comes to the trade courses. So as I mentioned previously also, trade course is basically certificate 3. It can be certificate 4. It can be diploma. It's not compulsory to be, it should be, three of them. Some colleges have certificate 3 of 2 years. Some colleges have certificate 3 of 1 year, certificate 4 of 6 months, diploma of 6 months, or certificate 4 of 1 year. In either of the scenarios, you should be fine to apply for your TRA or 485 later on. Simple Preet is also joining us. She'll be later on covering more of the migration side or the visa sides for you. But as of now, education is something which we can take care of, we can talk about.
Yeah.
So basically, when it comes to pathways, you can either if you want to apply for your visa just for the trade courses, then if you meet the general entry requirement which we had discussed before, you can apply for your trade course and apply for your visa from there on. Otherwise, to say for that matter, if you're already here on bachelor's,
mm-hmm.
And on higher education visa, or
yes.
say on master's,
yeah.
So you can study a concurrent course as well.
Okay,
so that is
came in exactly on the same one, and
okay.
I would like to get Simple Preet course thinking in here as well.
Absolutely,
that, that when a student is studying masters, as you said, Himanshu, that they can do it concurrently at the same time they study. Simple Preet, can you please tell us, is there any problem when it goes forward for the visa? Will there be any issue there?
No, there is not going to be any problem if a student studies a course concurrently along with master's or bachelor's. So, see, nowadays, most of the people, they are keeping an option of the trade occupations along with their higher qualification, because most of the people, they are not able to, meet the point requirements in like IT, accounting or engineering. So they definitely keep a backup option of the trade course. So, it is just a student that how do they manage the study load? I mean, they can study the trade course in the second year, maybe of the their master's qualification, or maybe in the last semester, or cool. Also they can study a trade course on the TR 485 visa as well. But they have to make sure that there is a visa duration of 2 years left when they're starting their trade course. So at least they can complete their job ready program as well in order to be eligible for skill assessment.
Excellent. Okay.
Yeah.
We'll come back to you, Himanshu. Sorry to cut you off there.
No. I am very happy because, immediately we can always sort out we are sorting out the question, answering the question for the students as well. So I'm sure they'll be happy with that too. So basically, when we were talking about certificate 3, the concurrent studies. So say if the student is studying a bachelor's degree or a master's degree, they can study a certificate 3 concurrently. So certificate 3 is usually 1 year.
Mm-hmm.
So now what Simple Preet just mentioned about the study load, I would just like to highlight that a bit more, that when we're talking about study load, then the college, when you start, where you will be studying a certificate 3 concurrently, they would be asking you, or they would need an assurance that you would be able to meet the study load or not. Study load of your university from where you are studying your bachelor's degree.
Yes.
Because at the end of the day, you are taking care of 2 courses.
Mm-hmm.
Even though certificate 3, the studies won't be that heavy, for you to take care of. But maybe your bachelor's or master's, might not allow you that much time to take care of 2 courses. Okay. In most of the cases, I have seen students nailing through it. It's quite comfortable for the students to manage bachelor's with a trade course, with a certificate 3.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just that you have to make sure, you have to provide a statutory declaration to the colleges that yes, you know, it has to be a formal one, you know, in which you mention that, yes, I'm studying this particular course like bachelor's or master's, mm-hmm. and I'll be taking care of my study load. And with that, I'll be able to manage my certificate 3 along with my university studies as well.
Yes.
Sometimes the colleges also ask you to provide your timetable as well, because they would want to see that if these days you are going to the college in your previous university, in your current university, like bachelor's or master's, how would you be able to cope up with the number of days that they want you to, the trade courses, you know, the colleges want you to come for also.
True.
So this is how the whole concurrent things work.
Yeah, I would like to add on one more thing. When people, they are taking the trade course concurrently, they have to make sure that they are studying their principal course, you know, properly. I mean, otherwise it will be a breach of student visa condition. I mean, you have to study the principal course plus the trade course as well.
Thank you. Yeah, that's the most important point as well.
Yeah,
that's pretty much, you know, for the pathways for, you know, using concurrent studies, you know, you have an option. It's not like, you know, it's not the end of the world, you know, for you to not to study trade course. Concurrent study is official, and you can definitely do that, you know, as mentioned by our migration agent Simple Pete as well.
Yeah.
So when we're talking about, you know, more about pathways, you need to keep in mind that trade course that you're studying should be 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
So it should be technically more than 92 to 96 weeks. It should be more than that. I think Simple Pete will be able to, you know, highlight that.
So when you are studying only a trade course, then you have to make sure you're studying for at least 2 years so that you can be able to apply for 485 visa for a graduate work stream later on. But then if you are studying a certificate 3 only, so then it has to be 1 year at least. I mean, so that you can be eligible for the job ready program.
True.
Absolutely.
But some courses like Kukri and, you know, in Kukri, if you do certificate 3, you'll be only eligible to get the skill assessment as cook. But then if you do certificate 4 along with that as well, then you'll be able to get the skill assessment as chef. So it depends on the occupation. If the skill assessment authority requires a certificate 3 only, or if it requires certificate 4 as well. But most of the occupations require, you know, certificate 3 only. So yeah, it depends on the requirement that if you are doing your trade course on 485 visa, I mean, along... maybe if you have done bachelor's or master's, then you can go for 1 year trade course. But then if you want to apply for TR, you have to study at least 2 years. And you can combine Cert 3, Cert 4 and diploma. Or maybe if a certificate 3 is 2 years, you can go for that only. You can combine certificate 3 or certificate 4 as well, if it is making the study duration for 2 years.
Yeah. For any individualistic questions, you can go to Simple Preet.
Yes.
Okay, so Himanshu, you covered pretty much the entry requirements and the pathways. We're not going to go to each and every one in the panel, because pretty much all over Australia, they remains the same. Mm-hmm. Now, can we start with Mickey in Brisbane? Mickey, can you please tell us what are the colleges which provides the courses? Talk about carpentry, painting, and wall and floor tiler, which are the main courses what students ask us about. So can you please explain those ones?
So thanks, Mangarish. Now, I think we're going to start with the carpentry. So when we talk about carpentry, we got an option of studying only certificate 3 in carpentry for a duration of 2 years. Or we could combine this certificate 3 in some colleges with the duration of 1 year of certificate 3 and another year of diploma of building and construction. Now we've got four major players in the industry here in Brisbane and Gold Coast. So we've got SITS Institute, which has got a campus in Salisbury, and I'm going to talk about the tuition fees is $27,000 for the certificate 3 and the diploma put together for 2 years, and they're currently offering 10% scholarship as well on this fees. And the 360 hours, which is a mandatory requirement, work placement, volunteer or paid, is included in the course duration and is guaranteed by the institute itself. And the college also not guarantee, but helps the students for the JRP program, which is required after completion of this course, which is obviously a mandate for qualification assessment, as mentioned by Simple Pete as well. So After completing this course, obviously you need a JRP program, so they're going to assist you with that. The second institute that we're going to discuss about is Everthought College, which offers only Certificate 3 in Carpentry. Again, it's a two-year course. It has got intakes in January, March, June, August, and October. The course fees starts from $28,000 for the whole course, and they've got a campus here again in Brisbane, Moorooka. Then I'm going to talk about the third college, which is McKellen College, and they also have only Certificate 3 in Carpentry for 2 years. And their courses start every month, so they've got an intake every month, and the tuition fees for this college, McKellen College, is going to be $24,500 for the full duration of the course, which is 2 years, and they also guarantee a work placement for 400 hours. That's included in the course for 2 years. They've got a campus in Yerongpilly, which is again Brisbane campus. Mm-hmm. We've got an option for regional area with TAFE Queensland. You could take Certificate 3 in Carpentry for 104 weeks, which is again 2 years, but the intakes for this course is only going to be July and January 2021. Now, the only thing that we need to be concerned about this TAFE Queensland is they're not going to be accepting any concurrent studies. So if you're looking for concurrent studies, this is not an option for you. The tuition fees obviously is a little bit lower as compared to others. It's going to be $22,800 for the two-year course. And they also have a campus in Gold Coast and Sunshine Coast, which is a regional area. So that's an added benefit. You get extra 5 points for migration purposes. That's all from Brisbane regarding Certificate 3 in Carpentry and Diploma of Building and Construction. So if I think we're going to discuss about painting and Tyler later, I'll let the other states continue with carpentry first.
Sure.
Back to you, Mangarish. Thank you very much, guys.
The one good thing about one more benefit of going to, you know, trade courses is the courses basically start on a, you know, very short interval. So they start either monthly or either quarterly. So the intakes are more and students can join on a quite regular basis compared to like a university course, which is like February or July or even October.
Absolutely right.
The Gold Coast is very beautiful. And yeah, and then it is to get 5 points, you know, for the area study. Yeah.
Excellent. Shrey from Sydney, can you please tell us about Sydney scenario?
Well, Sydney would have, as I said, carpentry courses. There are, I think, three major places in Sydney as well. As the Master said, McKellen College also has a campus in Sydney. So the same thing, everything that just Himanshu said, same kind of fee structure, same intakes, everything keeps the same.
Yeah.
Other than that, we have two other colleges in Sydney.
Mm-hmm.
Trinity College is the first one, that is Trinity Institute. They just have recently started the course just now. Same Carpentry Certificate 3 in Carpentry, 2 year of course, completely, no need to do any other diploma courses, complete 2 year will be covered in it. Fees is around 27,500, but they always have as usual installment plans for their students. They also provide partial, they don't provide the entire work placement, but they do provide a partial work placement for every student that they have.
Yep.
And obviously, if they perform well in everything, they can obviously help them out in the future as well. Apart from that, intakes everyone, they have almost have every intake for every month apart from March and October.
Yep.
So, it's a pretty nice option as well for everyone. And the campus, the good part about all three colleges are, they are all located in Parramatta, Harris Park region. So everything is in Brisbane. There's nothing in CBD.
Excellent. Okay.
The second option, apart from McAllen and Trinity, the third one is AHMI, Australian Health and Management Institute.
Yeah.
They also have the 104 week of carpentry course, 2 year again. The fees is $24,000.
Okay.
They have intakes every month.
Excellent.
So pretty much flexible, same options such as any other states. But all of them are in Western Sydney. So it's a really good option.
Yes. I've got a question for Simpalpreet. Vishal is asking, can a part, if someone is on partner visa, can they start studying or do they need a student visa to study?
So if they're on a partner visa, if they have the study rights, yes, definitely they can study a partner visa. So now people, some people just think if they're on student dependent, they are on a partner visa. If they're on TA dependent, they're on a partner visa. But it depends that which partner visa they are on. If they're on a permanent visa, yes, they can. But then if they're on a temporary visa, then definitely they have to get their own student visa to study.
Excellent. And one more question, Simple Preet. Vandan is asking, when we do a concurrent course, our 485, will it be applied based on a principal course or the concurrent course?
Yes, it is going to be applied based on the principal course. And anyway, let's assume that if you have studied bachelor's degree or master's degree, so you will get 24 months of 485 visa. But if you study trade course as the principal course, then you get 18 months of 485 visa.
Okay, understood. Perfect. Yeah. Now we'll come back to our homeland. Himanshu from Melbourne, can you please tell us about the colleges?
Yeah, sure. I mean, we have a few colleges in Melbourne, since the market is quite huge here. You know, for people to go for the trade courses, especially in construction. So when I talk about carpentry, we do have Howard International College. You know, which we can, so basically the fees is, you know, when I talk about all of these construction courses, especially, starting from certificate 3, or for the entire package, you know, for 2 years, it's ranging between 22 to 24.
Okay.
Usually for construction, it's a bit on this side, for other trade courses like cookery, it's a bit lesser, it's more reasonable, but for construction, it's ranging between 22 to 24 in Melbourne.
All right.
So talking about the colleges, it can be Howard International College, which is based somewhere in the city. Mm-hmm. You can also you can do carpentry from Della International College as well, which is in the city as well. And there are other options, which we'll be happy to talk over call as well. If you would like to reach out to us, there are other options for you to study carpentry. When we talk about other trade courses in construction, it can be painting as well. So when I talk about painting, they can be.
We'll come back to painting. We'll just pretty much sorting out for carpet. I'm sure the colleges would be the same.
Sure. Yeah. So basically, the colleges which are offering carpentry, have other construction courses also. Not all of them, but the major ones. So these are the ones which we can discuss maybe.
Sure. Excellent. Manpreet, our neighbor, can you please tell us about Adelaide?
Finally. Thank you, Mangirish. I've not been this quiet in my life, I guess.
I know. Yes.
So thank you very much. For Adelaide, for carpentry, we only have one provider, Center of Excellence. But before that, I would like to touch base a little bit on entry requirement from offshore, actually, because we've pretty much talked about the onshore and the waiver of English on the basis of 2 years of study. But if you are planning on to get your admission sorted from offshore, then you need to have English. If you come from a level 3 country, for example, from India, Nepal, Kenya, or some of the other countries which are level 3. So English is must, because it's part of the departmental requirement. So that will be there, because we cannot organize a placement test, since you need to either go to the college or institute for the placement test, or you need a supervised test, for which we cannot obviously do it if we are sitting in Australia and they are offshore. So that is one thing I would like to cover up. And then moving forward towards the pathways and the colleges, then we have one college for certificate 3 in painting. We're talking about carpentry. We have McAllen College. It's 2 years of program. Tuition fees is 26,000. Other than that, we do not have any other provider for carpentry, unfortunately, because it has been just introduced last year. So we are still hoping that in coming years we'll have more provider. We also have diploma for building and construction and certificate 4 of building and construction. So for that, we have 3 provider. We have TAFE SA, we have Center of Excellence, and then we have McAllen College. The fees ranges, it depends. If you're looking after 1 year of course for certificate 4, it'll be 52 weeks, and the fees will be 13,500 roughly. If you're looking at a diploma of building and construction, then again, it will be, it depends. If you're pairing it with certificate 4 leading to diploma, then it'll be 52 weeks. If you're looking at just studying diploma of building and construction, then it'll be a couple of years, and the fees will be roughly 24,500. Then it depends if the university offers any scholarship, then it'll be less. That's it for the Adelaide.
Yeah, excellent. Naman, can you please tell us about Perth?
Yeah, thanks, Manrish. So in WA, we have two education providers, which are providing the Certificate 3 in Carpentry, and the duration of the course is 2 years. And in TAFE, we have intake, it's February and then July. And entry requirement in TAFE is quite different. It depends on country to country. So mainly from India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Nepal, they ask for the IELTS 6, no band less than 5.5. And for other countries, they have the 5.5 and no less than 5. And same with the equivalent to PT score. And the fees is around 27,000 for the entire duration of the course in TAFE. And next provider we have in WA is the Everthought College of Construction. And they have intake January, March, and the upcomings are the July and October intake. The requirement is 5.5, no band less than 5 in Everthought College, and the fees is around 28,950 for the entire duration of the course.
Okay, excellent. Perfect. I'm getting one question for Simpalpreet. The person is saying, what are the options after finishing trade course? Will there be an option for a permanent residency in Australia?
Yes, definitely there is an option of permanent residency, and the trade courses are the most, you know, common options or most, you know, trending options for the PR at the moment. So, if you want to apply based on the points for trade occupations, then the requirement is 90 to 95 points. But then again, if you are not able to meet the point requirement of this 90 to 95, then there are state options, and people can go to different states. They have to be, most of the states are having the requirement of to be a graduate of that particular state, or you need to have work experience in that particular state. I can describe the requirements at the end of the session. So I'll tell all the requirements of all the states at the end of the session, and for each state.
Thank you so much. Going back to Mickey from Brisbane. Mickey,
yes.
We pretty much discuss about carpentry. Now, painting, I'm sure painting and wall and floor tiler, of course, the colleges would be similar, or is there any difference?
Oh, definitely different colleges. So okay. We don't have common institutes or providers for those. Okay. But I'll start with the painting and decoration first. Yeah, and so we're talking about Certificate 3 in Painting and Decoration here in Queensland. So we've got two providers offering this course. The major provider, which is offering 94 weeks course for this particular, is one, the Peach Bryan Institute. And now they have got a campus in Brisbane and Gold Coast. So if you're looking for 5 extra points for regional, 94 weeks qualifies for the criteria, and regional Gold Coast, so you're looking at 5 extra points for your migration purposes. The entry requirement is the same as every other institute. The tuition fees for this is 20,000, and they're also offering a 10% scholarship because of COVID-19. And they have a monthly intake. So guys, if you're interested in joining a painting course at Gold Coast, this is the only option we have as of now. And another provider we have for Certificate 3 in Painting and Decoration is ANIB, that is Australian National Institute of Business. Now, but the problem here is we've got a duration gap here. It's only 60 weeks, the course duration. They have a monthly intake. The course fees for this institute is $10,000. They've got a campus in Brisbane. If somebody is looking to do a painting and decoration course on their 485 visa, as mentioned by Simple, I think this would be a good option. They can finish it in 60 weeks, so they don't have to go for the full duration of 2 years.
Yeah.
But if you're looking for a 485 visa option after finishing your painting course, I don't think this would be a good option. Yes, and when it comes to Certificate 3 in floor and wall tiling, we've got two providers here in Queensland, which one of them is Everthought College of Construction. They have got intakes in January, March, July, and October is the next one, two intakes. The entry requirements again remain the same. The tuition fees for this course at Everthought is $25,500. They have a special offer for COVID-19 pay $1,000 to get the COA, which is unusual. So why don't take the benefit of that? So if you're interested in volunteer float hiring, you can get a COA for $1,000. And then again, we've got another institute in Gold Coast, which is offering volunteer float hiring, which is entrepreneur education.
Yeah.
The course fees for entrepreneur education is $18,000. Mm-hmm. And again, it's in Gold Coast, so you can attain 5 regional points for your migration purposes if you finish this course. It's again a 93 weeks course duration, which is good. Completes the criteria for 2 years of education. Now, they have got on offer again 10% scholarship, and you pay $2,500 for a COA to get enrolled into one of these courses. And the entry requirement is year 10 actually for this course here at Entrepreneurial Education, so you don't even have to have a year 12. IELTS still remains the same as 5.5. That's it from Queensland. So we only have these four providers for these two courses. So back to you, Mangreesh.
Excellent. Thank you. Now I'm going to talk to Manpreet because she said that you didn't give us a chance. So Manpreet, that's right now, it's your chance. Can you please tell us about Adelaide, our neighbor?
Sure. Cute neighbor. So for Adelaide, if we talk about the painting, we only have one provider. We are hoping we'll have more provider in the coming years. So we have Center of Excellence who have started to offer Certificate 3 in painting and decorating. It's a 52 weeks of program. However, they have 2 years of package program with this one, so they can pair it with Diploma of Building and Construction. So you can have 2 years of package program. So the cost for Certificate 3 in Painting and Construction is $13,000. Okay. But due to COVID, they have a $500 scholarship for every student for the upcoming intake. So if anybody's interested, they can avail $500 scholarship. So the cost will be $12,500 for painting and decorating and for Diploma of Building and Construction both. Other than that, we don't have any providers. So that'll be
July intake, right?
Yeah. So they have monthly intakes. They're very flexible. So if you're not able to make it to July, we can always request for the upcoming intake. So they're very flexible in terms of offering this course.
Sure. Excellent. Thank you. We go back to Shrey from Sydney. Shrey, I just received a message saying, what are the chances of automotive in New South Wales? I'm on TR and I have completed Cert 3 in automotive.
Cert 3 in automotive, I think NSW does have that in automotive thing if they have finished Cert 3.
Okay.
Just in case if anyone's having the new requirements, they have just opened.
Okay. Sure.
I think Simple
Preet
can actually jump in for that. If
that. So, see, I mean, if somebody has done Certificate 3 in automotive, NSW is offering basically 190 and 491 as well. And if an automotive occupation, a motor mechanic, does not require, doesn't have any additional criteria on NSW's side, so then you can definitely apply for NSW 190, but the point requirement is to have 70 to 75 to get the invitation. But if it is 491 for motor mechanics, so then you have to be living in NSW, you have to be well established in NSW, so which means you have to provide the address proofs like bank statement, lease agreement, or the utility bills you have to provide to be eligible to apply for a motor mechanic in NSW.
How many points you need to remember, Simple Preet? I don't know. Okay. Let's not go in there. Shrey, can you please tell us about the colleges?
Okay. So now we're talking painting and decorating actually. Painting and decorating, we only have literally two options here. AHMI is the common one here. AHMI does offer Certificate 3 in painting and decorating.
Yeah.
Which is entirely for 2 years. So even if you want to just apply for a TR after it, they can pretty much do it after the Certificate 3.
Yeah.
They're offering, the fees is around $24,000 right now. Mm-hmm. They all have entry requirements. The common entry requirements for everyone, 5.5 and 5 inch. And takes every month, again, the usual thing. However, TAFE is also offering Certificate 3 in painting and decorating, which is for, again, 1 year.
Okay.
Now, 1 year, they will have the thing about TAFE is they only have two intakes, everyone. They do either Feb or in July, two intakes. And again, Best part, it's again in it, the campus is in Granville, again Western Sydney, and both can be leading. So they have the option to either go for at least 3 years of either go for certificate 3, then lead to certificate 4 of building and construction, and then diploma of building and construction. But they also have this 2-year option of just certificate 3 of building and construction leading. Certificate 3 of painting and decorating leading to certificate 4 of building. And now, if someone who is on DR, if they just want to do certificate 3 of painting and decorating,
yeah,
1 year course.
So yeah,
anyone who's on DR, I think, okay. And they take is pretty flexible when it comes to the admissions as such.
Okay.
And certificate 4, if you want to do, if someone wants to go for a complete 2 year, then they can either literally go for certificate 3 and certificate 4. The overall fee for that package comes up to around $31,000. Again, the other two, I think we have to talk about bricklaying and block laying as well. Again, it's only offered by TAFE. And again, 2 intakes, and they can club with certificate 4 of building and construction or diploma of building and construction.
Mm-hmm. We lost you there. Can't hear you, Shrey.
Now?
Yeah, we can hear you now.
Okay. So again, TAFE certificate 3 of bricklaying and block laying. 1 year each, 1 year of certificate 3, and you can either go for certificate 4 or diploma if you want to go on for the next intake.
Okay.
Really, all the campuses that they have, mm-hmm. the campuses are almost all in Western Sydney only.
Okay.
Again, however, if you want to do a diploma course from TAFE, they have a campus in city, Ultimo okay. campus. It's in the CBD only.
Yeah.
Apart from it, there's only certificate 3 in wall and floor tiling. That's also offered at TAFE.
Okay.
And certificate 3 will cost you 16,460, 1 year of course. And it's actually the most unique campus out of all. The campus is in Macquarie Fields, actually. So it's just
beautiful. Yeah.
Kind of behind Royal National Park. So it's a good view from there, I guess.
Yes.
And obviously, you can club it with diploma of building and construction. And building and construction is almost offered at all the Western City, Western campuses, and CBD campus as well.
That's right.
Apart from it, I think that's pretty much it for all painting sure. decorating from my side.
Excellent. No problem. Naman, can you please tell us about Perth?
Yeah, in Perth, so unfortunately at the moment, we don't have any education provider for painting course.
Okay.
Yeah, so I would like to move to certificate 3 in wall and floor tiling. We have 3 education providers. TAFE mm-hmm. is there, Avathot College of Construction, and the Perth College of Business and Technology. In TAFE, the same, the intakes are February and July, and the fees is around 27,000 for the entire duration of the course.
Mm-hmm.
And Avathot, again, the same intakes, January, March, and July, October. And mm-hmm. fees is around 29,000 for the 2 years. Entry requirements are same. And the next we have PCBT, that's the Perth College of Business and Technology. They mm-hmm. have only 1 intake, and that's the February intake. Their
yep.
entry requirements are quite less. They need only 5 in IELTS, and each band not less than 5. And the yep. same with the equivalent with the PT and TOEFL. So sure. that's all we have for the wall and floor tiling. So
excellent.
In W, we have the certificate 3 in bricklaying. Again, the education providers are TAFE and Avathot, and the same entry requirements and fee structures and intakes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's
okay.
pretty much about the WAF.
Perfect. Thank you. Himanshu, you're the last one in this category. Can you please tell us about Melbourne?
Last man standing.
Yes.
All right. So when we talk about Melbourne, I would like to discuss, the colleges option that we have in the city
mm-hmm.
or the inner suburbs, which is city inner suburbs, I can say. Also, I will discuss one option that you have to study, a trade course or basically a painting course in Geelong as well.
Okay.
So maybe starting with Geelong.
Mm-hmm.
We also have, just like Adelaide, Manpreet mentioned that they have Center of Excellence who's providing painting course there. We do also have Center of Excellence who's providing the paint certificate 3 in painting. With of course, if it's overall would be 2 years course, along with certificate 4 or diploma. So they have a 2 years package as well, along with certificate 3 in painting. So the fees again would be ranging, as I mentioned, I won't be covering the fees because the difference is not, you know, that much. So the fees is ranging between 22 to 24 or 25 for all of these trade courses, you know, which are for 2 years. So the entry requirement is pretty much the same. So yeah, so the only why, you know, the reason why I, you know, I thought of mentioning Geelong because it's a regional area. And the students who will be studying 2 years in Geelong, which is a regional area of Victoria, and living there and will be living there for those 2 years would also be eligible for those 5 extra points, you know, for their, you know, basically future pathways later on for their permanent residency. Also, you know, if you are studying a particular course from Geelong, I am sure that the providers or the work experience that you'll be having, you'll be more, you know, you'll be having more exposure to the people who are, you know, offering the jobs there. You can have, you know, you can have their work experience sorted. So it can help you with your prospects for future job offer, full-time job offer in the regional area, so that it can help you for your 491 state nomination of Victoria as well, which I think Simple Preet would be taking care toward the end of this live session. Yeah. So when I talk about the Certificate 3 in painting options in the city, mm-hmm. you have Howard International College, you know, who have Certificate 3 in painting. You also have Della International College. So all of these options that I'm mentioning right now are in the city. So it's quite convenient for the people to use public transport, if you know, or to travel to the city and, you know, study from here, from the city. Yes. Apart from that, you have in the city, you have Jen Institute, mm-hmm. who also have Certificate 3 in painting. So you can, you know, you have quite varied options, you know, quite a variety of options from, you know, in the city. Apart from that, you have Orange International College, mm-hmm. also have Certificate 3 in painting. Mm-hmm. So you can study your painting from, you know, one of these institutes. Yeah. Apart from that, you also have Certificate 3 in painting from Oceania Polytechnic.
Okay.
Oceania Polytechnic is quite a popular or like, you know, lucrative option for someone to go for. Why? Because it not only has painting options, mm-hmm. it has wall and floor tiling.
Yeah.
At the same time, they also have solid plastering as well.
Okay.
Which is also quite in demand because students these days, you know, are looking for those options which are not that common, which are a bit, you know, uncommon or like, you know, those options which not many people are going for.
Yes.
But there's a confusion, like, you know, which the student have in their mind that if a particular occupation or if a particular trade course like carpentry, if more and more people are going for that, you know, that means that the demand for that particular you know, trade course also is quite high as well.
Yes.
So it's not just about, you know, following what people are doing. It's about, you know, of course, choosing the right option. So basically, having a discussion with the migration agent before choosing these options is always a great idea. And this is where we also are really helpful because we bridge the gap, you know, for the students to study that particular course, which is good for them.
Yes.
And because we are always connected with the migration agents and we get trained from them as well, you know, when it comes to all the pathway information and everything.
Yes.
That's pretty much it from Melbourne.
Okay, perfect. No problem. Now, Simple Preet, we've got a question for you. Someone is basically on temporary residence, so they are on TR right now after finishing their trade course, and they want to again apply for TR. Is that possible?
TR can be applied only once. If a person has already applied for 485 visa, they cannot apply it second time. But yes, if they have a partner and if their partner studies and apply 485 visa, yes, they can, you know, their partner can apply and they can be on 485 dependent, but a person who has already applied for 485 visa cannot apply it again.
Yeah, okay, sure. No problem. Thank you. Now, guys, education team, we have 5 more minutes to cover our wall and floor tiling. So we'll try to cover and then rest. We will go back to Simple Preet because she has so much information. I don't know how she remembers everything, but she would like to share all that information. So we would like to pass it on to her. Miki, starting from you again, can you please tell us about wall and floor tiling, please?
I guess I've already covered wall and floor tiling with Entrepreneur and Everthought College.
Sure.
If you want me to go through it again.
No, if you covered, that's okay. That's fine.
Yeah, and yeah, I think it's time for Simple Preet to discuss it.
Shrey from Sydney.
Again, I think I also went through it once.
Perfect.
And it's in TAFE again. I would just
yes.
more.
Yeah.
One option only. Different, yeah. Just campus and 16,460 is the fees for them.
Okay, sure. Himanshu, we've covered our backyard as well.
Yes, we've done. It's just that one more thing, you know, I would just like to mention that it's not just with carpentry and painting course, like, you know, with any other trade course like solid plastering, you know, how Shrey mentioned about bricklaying and blocklaying, you know, all of these courses, you know, student can definitely consider, because it's, they're not that known by the students, you know, because they mostly are in touch, you know, with the students who have previously graduated from Australia with these trade courses. So they're not aware about the new trade courses, you know, who have recently, you know, come into market, and yes, which might, you know, be handy for them to basically, like, you know, go to their, you know, nearby counselors and talk about them.
Yeah.
So, yeah, and of course, these trade courses like Certificate 3 in wall and floor tiling, solid plastering, and all of those can also be done concurrently, as I previously mentioned.
Perfect. Cool. Thank you. Manpreet, Naman, both of you, option floor is open for you. You want to shed some light?
Maybe in future. Unfortunately, we don't have. Okay. But we're still a beautiful state if you want to come in.
Indeed.
So much to enjoy.
Right now, you're not allowing any people to come to your state. So, not liking that.
Probably after that comment.
Naman, can you please tell us about Perth?
Yeah, all... covered all the construction grade courses. Yeah, besides that, I just want to add that one of the popular courses among these construction is yes, the diploma and advanced diploma of civil and structural engineering. So it's quite famous, quite popular here, because it's, I guess it's in the WL list.
Yes.
But it's also available in TAFE, and it's for 2 years. Entry requirements are 6, no band less than 5.5, and yeah, available intakes are February and July, and the fees is around 30,000 for the entire duration of the course.
Okay, excellent. No problem. Simpleprit, floor is yours now. We've got so many questions, but the one question what I have is, recently I've been hearing only 490 and 191. Now, please tell us what are these, because I have, to be honest with you, not got no idea about it. So it's okay, yours.
Let me tell you the subclasses first. So sure. 189, 189 is skilled independent visa, which means it is totally point based. It is independent of any states, and you have to meet 90 to 95 points, you know, the cutoff criteria, and then you will get the invitation.
Mm-hmm.
190 is the state nomination. And for this visa subclass, you need to have 60 points by yourself and 5 points you get from the state to be eligible for, you know, 190. But along with that, you have to meet the state requirements as well. I mean, and you can apply with 60 points by yourself.
Yes.
And 491 visa is, you need to have 50 points by yourself and 15 points you get from the state. This is a state nomination as well. But yes, 491 is a pathway to PR, and I mean, you get 5 years of visa, 3 years you have to stay in regional, you have to work in regional, and you have to have an income of $53,900 per annum, and then you apply for 191 visa, and that is PR. But yes, anyway, most of the people, they are focusing on 491 nowadays. I mean, it is just because, I mean, the requirements are easier as compared to, you know, 189 or 190. So I'm gonna talk about state options today. And since we are focusing more on construction courses like carpentry, of wall and floor tiler, and painting, so I'll be telling you the requirements of all the states. And I'm just going to give you a brief, but then if anybody needs more of the details, then they can contact me, and I'll give you my phone number as well. I'll put it on the link as well.
Sure.
So if you have any other questions, you can ask me first, and then I'll
start. No, go ahead. If I get any, I'll definitely poke you. Sorry for that.
Yeah, sure. Okay, so let's start with Northern Territory. So Northern Territory has recently updated the requirements for 190 and 491. So for 190, the requirement is to study over there for 2 years. And also you should be staying over there for 6 months after the completion of your study. But that visa should be 485 visa or any other visa which is allowing you to work over there for full time. And also you have to demonstrate that you have tried to find a job in your particular field over there. So in short, we can say that, I mean, Northern Territory 190 is only for those people who are over there, who came over there initially on the student visa. All right. So it is only for them. Yes. But other people, they can go for 491 visa. But what do they need to do is they need to have 6 months of work experience over there mm-hmm. the relevant field, in the eligible occupation, and a one year of job offer letter over there. Okay, so that is how they can apply for 491. So any other, you know, people who are over there studying for 2 years, they can apply for 491 if they are not able to apply 485 visa later on, but they need to work over there for 6 months in the relevant field and then they can apply.
Okay.
And in Northern Territory, only carpenter occupation is there. Wall and floor tiler and painting occupation is not there. So the carpenters can choose an option of Northern Territory.
Okay.
Then coming to South Australia, Manpreet. South Australia is offering 491 visa for all these three occupations, carpenter, painting, and wall and floor tiler. But then people can apply for 190 for South Australia as well if they have 1 year of work experience over there, or if they have 6 months of relevant work experience in regional areas of South Australia. So most of the people, they will get 491 in South Australia because, I mean, to get 190, you have to show a real commitment to South Australia that you will be living over there. I mean, you have been living over there from a longer period. You have got a particular job over there in the relevant field. You have got a very good, you know, package of the salary that you, I mean, you have to prove that you will not coming back to, you will not be coming back to any other state, but you will be staying in South Australia for a longer period. But I mean, South Australia definitely offers 491 visa to all these three occupations, but you need to have 6 months of work experience over there in South Australia, and that has to be at least 40 hours per fortnight.
Okay.
And then coming to Tasmania. So Tasmania doesn't offer 190 for these three occupations, but definitely offers 491. And for Tasmania, you have to be a graduate of Tasmania, and that requires 1 year of study, at least 40 weeks of study in Tasmania. Yep. Or you need to have 6 months of work experience, full-time work experience in any of the fields in Tasmania, but you have to show the commitment. Again, you have to show that you will be able to, I mean, if you're working over there for 6 months, you have to show that you are getting enough, good enough package of salary that you will be able to meet the future requirements of 491. Okay. Yes. And also if you're studying over there for 1 year, so you have to show that how did that course help you to, you know, help you in any way in Tasmania. You have to write about your career plan, that how did Tasmania help you, you know, in your career, or maybe that course help you in your career, or the work experience you're going to have over there, how is that going to help you? So that is how you show the commitment in Tasmania. And only then Tasmania will give you 491 visa in these three trade occupations.
Yep.
And again, Canberra is only open for painting, not for carpenter or the wall and floor tiler. But in Canberra, you can go for both 190 or 491 as well. For 190, you need to have 6 months of work experience in Canberra. That has to be full time. And also, and for 491, you need to have 3 months of work experience, and that can be part-time as well. It is not mandatory that you should be working in relevant field. It can be in any field, but you have to make sure that your occupation is open in Canberra. And again, Canberra is totally different from other states. Canberra is having its own metrics. You have to meet the point requirements of its own metrics. And yeah, so if you meet that, then definitely you can choose Canberra as an option. But again, I cannot explain the entire metric here, so it has to be case to case basis. So I mean, the clients can contact me. And last is NSW.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the hot topic nowadays, because yesterday the requirements
I'm getting few questions for that as well, so I'll fire up those ones later.
Yeah, so for 190 NSW, the occupations which are on the NSW list, and if those occupations are requiring additional criteria, then that means you need to have 1 year of work experience in NSW in that particular field, and you should be staying over there in NSW as well, and only then you will get the 190 invitation. And if there is not any additional criteria in your occupation in NSW list, so yes, you can apply it here as well, and you need to have 70 to 75 points to get that invitation.
Yeah.
And the hot topic is 491. That was So for that, the requirement is just to be living in designated regional areas of NSW.
Okay.
But you have to provide the evidence for that as well. Mm-hmm. And the evidence are that you have to be, first of all, you'll have to be well established in NSW. So well established means there is not any definition of that, but maybe you can consider at least 3 months. You have been living in NSW for 3 months, and then you need to provide the bank statement, which is showing your transactions in NSW. Okay. And a lease agreement. You can you have to add a name in the lease agreement. You have to show the rental agreement, or you have to provide any of the evidence which shows that you have paid the rent in NSW. And the third mandatory document is that you have to show at least one utility bill in NSW as an evidence. Okay. So this is the basic requirement for NSW 491.
Yeah. So now 491 is pretty much kind of cap for the year. So do you think it will open up in next financial year?
Yes, I mean, it is just the end of financial year. So definitely, I mean, there will be some options available in the next financial year as well. So we have to wait for that. And here, why didn't I talk about Victoria, Western Australia and Queensland? Because these states are currently closed and these states will reopen in the end of July or maybe in the first week of August. I mean, in the next financial year with the new requirements.
Yes, yes. Excellent. Yeah. Would you like to add anything when it comes to migration? I think we pretty much covered all the aspects when it's
migration. I would just like to add on that if anybody is having any questions, they can contact me on 0414-020215. They can contact me in the office. And unfortunately, we are not taking clients in the office, but they can definitely contact me over the phone. And I can provide all the details over the phone as well.
Perfect. Thank you. Thank you so much, Simpalpreet. And thank you so much, guys. I know it's 6 o'clock, it's Friday. It's time to take some much needed rest after a week's hard work. Thank you so much again for your time. We will come back next week, not next, but the week after with one more interesting topic. We'll have one more person from immigration as well. So we'll try to solve as many questions as possible. There are so many questions here right now. So I'm sure we won't be able to go through each and every question. Apologies for that. But if you have any questions, as Simpalpreet said, they are mostly case-by-case basis. So if you guys can contact her, she'll be able to solve as many as possible. And have a good Friday. Just enjoy the rest of your weekend and see you next week. Thank you. Take care, guys. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.